lots of Japan happened again this week on Boss Battle.
Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you.
Welcome everybody to Boss Battle number 165, a show in which the writers of InsertCoinToBegin.com get together and talk about video games. I'm your host, Bobby F. Tom, but before we get into the infotainment and good time making of this podcast, let's see what everybody achieved this week. Chachi, how about you? What'd you achieve?
Yoshi's Woolly Island.
What?
Wow. Woolly World.
Woolly World.
Yeah, it's an entire universe now.
Yeah, which took my my amiibo count from zero and adamantly not buying amiibos to two. I bought two within 5 minutes of each other because I bought them at two different stores. I'm not even kidding. What's that?
You get the giant one?
No.
Oh, okay.
There's an exchange like half a block away from my place of employment. Mm-hmm. So I went into lunch and I went to go pick up Woolly World, only to find out that exchange sold out at 9:01 a.m.
Oh, wow. They are right there for you guys on screen.
They open at 9.
Wow.
But luckily, the one on Liberty Avenue down the street from Tunzium had one and held it for me. But while I was at the original, I bought a pink Yoshi amiibo. For the fiance, mm-hmm. and the bundle I got came with the green one.
Oh, that's cool.
So I
ended up now you have best Yoshi friends.
Yes,
and I know like some of the amiibos, like not even the Yoshi amiibos, but say like I have Luigi. If you put that on your thingy, if you put that on here, it will turn your Yoshi into a Luigi Yoshi.
Yeah, well, the whole thing with Yoshi Woolly World is that Kamek came back,
mm-hmm.
and he disassembled all of the yarn Yoshis.
Oh no!
And took all the yarn to use for his own purposes. So as you go through the game, you are recreating. You're recreating new versions of the Yoshis he took, and it's all different themed. So each world has a different theme, or each level has a different themed Yoshi that you can collect and unlock. So, yeah, it makes me want to go out. I'm not kidding. It makes me want to go out and buy more amiibos.
Ah, there's that's
just so I can see them as Yoshi.
Chachi, I'm just saying this right now. You set a number for yourself, buddy.
Guys, I don't even have a Wii U.
I went in buying one, and now I've got three, which one being a Japan import.
I don't even have a Wii U, and I have an amiibo.
Yeah, I'm not running out to buy more amiibos. That's not happening.
You got Mega Man.
Yeah, I mean, if I come across a store that has, like, an 8-bit Mario, and I have the extra $10, or, you know, something Zelda... Mm-hmm. And I have the extra $10, then maybe. But I'm not actively looking for amiibos.
I'm gonna need my Ganondorf.
That's what you say now.
No. I am not a little
kid.
No, I have toys. I was gonna say I'm not like a little toy collector, but yeah. I have a lot of toys on my desk at work. Mm-hmm. So I mean, but those are mainly Legos.
I'm looking at my Mass Effect minifigs right now.
But I'm not a minifig collector. I'm not going to go out and start buying these when ultimately they have no purpose in the game.
Not really.
So, I mean, if they had more of a purpose, then I probably would buy them. But
just Yoshi costumes. And costumes, speaking of costumes, that's the theme of our show tonight.
Costumes?
Yes.
But were we supposed to wear costumes?
No, we weren't. No.
But
I wasn't going to, Bobby.
So I played that. I finally posted all of our Mario Maker levels on
mm-hmm.
on insertcointobegin.com.
And I'm really sorry.
It took me a while to do it, but I did it, and they're up there, and it will stay updated, and especially now because it'll be a lot easier to do. I don't have to create this thing from scratch again,
right?
Which I did on my Chromebook and was a pain in the ass, Sorg. Like, I did the entire thing on my Chromebook.
Hey, what'd you do?
That widget I created.
Oh, nice, nice.
I did it on my Chromebook, and it was a pain in the ass.
What did you use? Like for a graphic program?
Yeah. Hold on. I don't remember what it's called off the top of my head.
Welcome to AwesomeCast.
You should try Pixlr.com. Pixlr without the E.com.
Huh. But anyhow, yeah, so I created that on my Chromebook last night, and it'll be easier to update now. And about 10 minutes ago, I ordered an Xbox One. Please don't hurt me.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Chachi! Chachi is a friend of mine. Chachi is a friend of mine.
I found a good deal on the Assassin's Creed bundle.
Oh, good.
So I picked it up.
Is that the one with Unity and, or the new one?
No, it's Unity and Black Flag.
Okay, yeah, that's what I got. That's the bundle I got.
Yeah, so, I mean, as much as I wanted to be a good adult.
You're not a good adult.
No, I'm not a good adult.
It's fine, Chachi, it's fine.
Yeah. Adulting
can be put aside for a while.
Yeah.
Plus, it'll be the last big purchase I made for a while, so. Yeah, I got it's 500 gigabyte console, no Kinect because I'm not going to use it.
You'll need a bigger hard drive. I'm telling you right now.
That's fine. yeah, it comes with the two Assassin's Creed games, which we know is not a problem with me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
In time for the new one to come out.
Yeah, and new Call of Duty.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. Syndicate is probably the reason I pulled the trigger on it.
Mm-hmm.
The trailer looks good for that too. So.
Yeah, so that's probably why it happened. Horrible person. That's what I achieved this week.
All right, Sorg, how about you? What'd you achieve?
No.
All right. No. I've been playing the Jetpack Joyride Back to the Future 2 theme. That's it. That's all we can do.
Hey, that is fitting for tomorrow, because tomorrow is Back to the Future Day. If you're not familiar, October 21st, 2015 is when Marty McFly goes to the future and sees not flying cars that we have. The not flying cars. Anyways, Rizz, what did you achieve this week?
I achieved the normal things, like, you know, Mario Maker. Again, I'm really sorry. Chachi, you haven't played my latest levels yet.
No, that's fine.
Just know that our friendship may end when you play these.
Rizz, yes. Our friendship ended when you bought a PlayStation 4.
I'm kidding, buddy.
Oh, man. Audio listeners, good thing you're not seeing this right now. Good thing you're not seeing that right now. But... I have been playing Destiny, and the Taken King has this multiplayer level.
All right, we got Matt Carlin's leading over
into the show. Carlin's coming in. No, I got confused there for a minute.
Friend of the show, Matt Carlin.
But I've been playing this. It's called, I think it's just called Mayhem. It's Mayhem. It is just 10 minutes of just straight up team deathmatch with no, like, hesitations, quicker reloads, quicker everything. So it's a nice little fast motion type deal that is just one of those things where it gets you up there pretty good. It gets your guy leveled up pretty quick, and, like, when I first started, I was level 36, and I'm close to being 40.
Yay. So
I'm, like, almost, again, probably done with the game soon. Even though I haven't beaten anything from the Taken King yet.
That's fine. Just start over again.
But Bobby, that's about it.
Well, speaking of Destiny, you know how you guys give me crap for not beating games? Oh, I beat another one!
What'd you beat, Bobby?
I beat Destiny Story Mode!
Nice!
So I finished it this week. Unbeknownst to me.
Story mode.
Unbeknownst to me. Well, a lot of people gave the story a lot of crap, but I liked it. Although I didn't know I beat the game until I finished the boss battle. I'm like, did I beat it? Was that it? And then I saw the cutscene and I'm like, oh, that was it. And my phone's ringing.
Well, they said that it was supposed to be like a lot more in depth with it. But I guess there was more of a snafu, or if you will, on some stuff. That's why they have so much. They had to do so much backtracking, so much like story development in their DLC. I guess they didn't want to do it, but it just made it seem like it was faulty at best.
Yeah, they said they fleshed it out a lot in The Taken King, and it's actually got a good story now. It's a game that's going to continue anyway, so I mean,
when you're able to get your guy up to the max level without playing any of the DLC, that's pretty bad, because you can I finished both DLCs last week not even knowing I did it because I was so high of a level. So it is still good to go play it once in a while. But
yeah, well, I enjoy the game. I beat the game and I'm still playing it. So if that tells you, tell you something right there. I'm not finishing last in free for all multiplayer anymore. Mm-hmm. So that's a good thing. And I'm level like 32, I think now. So I'm getting up there. But yeah, that's what I played my usual like mobile games and stuff like that. But all right, Chachi, you want to send us around the net?
It's now time for the new Creep Theme Things!
Wow. Break.
Wow.
From around the internet. This week, so Kotaku taught me something that I didn't know.
I knew about this. Well, I didn't know one thing about it.
The town from Silent Hill, the movie adaption, is actually based off of a town in Pennsylvania. It is called Centrailia.
I knew about Centrailia. I didn't know it was based on that.
And essentially what happened is in 1962, mines under the town caught on fire. They have been unable to put them out.
Sounds like a bad episode of Minecraft.
Right. The state... reclaimed the land through eminent domain and forced everyone to move out for their own safety. And the residents, there was a lot of residents that refused to move, citing that they didn't think it was that dangerous. But finally in 2013...
It's still on fire.
Yeah. Let me just point out that the mines under the town are still on fire, and they've had to evacuate two other towns because of this. But there are people that are still living there, and they won the right to live there until they die in 2013.
I wouldn't say won.
Well, in court, they were awarded the ability to stay in their homes until they die in 2013.
Comma in 2013.
Yeah,
as in they won the right in 2013. They're going to die in 2013.
But anyhow, there are 10 people still living here, or living there, and only one of them is under 60.
Wow!
But that's according to the census in 2010.
They do.
I am glad you asked this.
They have a mayor of that town.
Wait, quick! Who is the poor census worker that had to go to that town?
Right. They don't have a mayor per se. They still have a borough council.
We'll draw straws to see who's the borough council.
Right. They meet regularly. The last thing that they had to decide was whether or not to pay the electric bill for the borough building.
Where do we put the firehouse now?
That was $92. Wow. That was the last thing that they had to decide. The borough maintains a positive budget or balance for the town
I
budget.
No.
We don't have to contend with snow.
Right.
Because of all the fire.
So, I put the link over to the article in it. You should look them up on Wikipedia. It's an interesting read.
I say boss battle road trip, guys.
I wonder if it's as foggy as Silent Hill.
Well, there are a lot of spots in the ground where a smoke still comes up.
Mm-hmm.
So, it might be. And I mean, it shut down parts of a state highway. So, I mean, it's not a safe town, but yeah, I still want to go.
Yeah.
But
it's Chernobyl.
Right. So next up, the world record time for beating Mario was beat again. It's down to 4 minutes and 57.627 of a second.
Made.
It is just getting ridiculous at this point. Listen, here's all I'm going to say on this, and then we're going to move on. I should be able to take a poop and not miss someone playing Mario.
I missed it.
That is you're right.
I should be able to comfortably go to the bathroom and not miss someone's entire Mario game. Moving on.
Yeah. This podcast brought to you by Fiber One this week. Fiber One.
Last but not least.
Make sure you can watch Mario.
Last but not least, my favorite YouTube channel, The Game Theorist, covered Bowser's backstory.
Mm-hmm.
And he may not be as evil as everyone thinks. It goes into the history of Bowser. It points out that while Super Mario Bros. 3, Super Mario World, and other games have said that the kids in those games are his children,
mm-hmm.
And Miyamoto says that they're not his children, that they may actually be adopted.
Aww.
Bowser adopted them because he himself may actually be an orphan.
Oh.
Which is what leads to him doing all of this bad stuff. He's just misunderstood, you guys.
So again, Mario's a dick.
Yeah, so once again, Mario's an asshole, and Bowser's just a nice guy who's misunderstood. Mm-hmm. Actually, I take that back. We can't say he's a nice guy, because he still does some evil shit. But he's not a horrible guy. And that's all I have for you this week on Video Game Thoughts from around the internet. Back to you, buddy.
All right, it's time for some things you should be made aware of. What do you get when you combine Call of Duty and Mirror's Edge?
Mirrors of Duty.
not quite. You get Black Ops... You get Black Ops 3's new multiplayer mode, Free Run. Free Run is a puzzle and time-based competition that made its debut during today's weekly Black Ops 3-themed live show. And utilizing the game's new movement system, which allows you to perform wall runs and other parkour-style moves. The mode consists of four time trial courses. Okay. There will also be weapon challenges, and the degree of difficulty will range from beginner to expert. So that's kind of a cool thing that they threw in, like a whole new mode for Call of Duty. It's basically...
Yeah, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
That's all right. It's basically air-themed parkour.
So now, are they still going to use weapons in this one?
Yeah, they said there were going to be weapons challenges. I don't know if it's going to be fighting.
Or is it just time trial based?
Like I think it's basically time trial based.
Okay, because I was going to say, there's still going to be some guy at the end of that level with a sniper doing no scope.
Yep.
Barely anybody plays gun game. I'm just going to say that right now. Gun game's a fun game to play, but barely anybody's playing it. Mm-hmm. Like the games that they have other than multiplayer, like team deathmatch and domination and all that stuff, nobody really wants to play that. It's a fun thing to have. Like I'm interested in playing it sometimes, but not going to be, spending my entire day playing that, because I'm going to go straight back to multiplayer people.
I think from what the article said, is it's basically a new mode, kind of like a tutorial to get people used to the new movement system in the game. Because they threw like kind of parkour style moves in there where you're going to be jumping off, running off walls and stuff like that. So, and it's the first time I think a Black Ops game has had that, right? I don't think, too, you could run up walls and stuff. So.
I think you're right. I'm trying to think of if Black Ops 2 had it, but I don't think they did.
I don't think it did.
Had what?
Multiplayer didn't.
Like parkour style moves where you run up walls and stuff.
No, it didn't.
Yeah. So it's Treyarch's first attempt at this kind of gameplay.
Well, hopefully they contacted Ubisoft for some tips.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, if they did, then Assassin's Creed-style parkour in a Call of Duty game would kind of be cool. Mm-hmm. But there needs to be a way to turn it off. Because
mm-hmm.
even in Advanced Warfare, you have the ability to play without the exosuits.
Yes.
You need to be able to turn it off, or people are just going to be pissed off.
All right. And our next story, Niantic, the company behind the eagerly anticipated Pokemon Go, just got a big boost from Nintendo, Google, or the Big Goog, as it was referred to on AwesomeCast, and the Pokemon Company. All three companies invested a combined total of $20 million into the company's future. John Hankey, the CEO of Niantic, in a press release said, yes, I know his name's Hankey, we will be using the capital to continue the development of Pokemon Go, to evolve and grow Ingress and its thriving global community, and to build out our real-world gaming platform. Ingress, if you're not familiar with it, is a massive online augmented reality RPG that was also developed by Niantic. The three
Ingress
companies
is evolving.
The three companies also plan to invest at least $10 million more based on certain conditions if they are met.
Is this a total of $20 million or $20 million each?
Total. A total combined thing of $20 million. So from all three companies, they're getting a sum of $20 million plus another 10 if they meet their conditions.
And I'm just making sure.
Yeah.
Because, I mean – $60 million is a hell of a lot of money to spend on a mobile game.
Yeah. But, I mean, it's cool to see that they see that this is going to be a pretty big thing. I mean, everybody's like freaking out. Everybody's freaking out about that trailer they released. Mm-hmm. So, I mean.
Oh, man.
If they can just see it.
I can just see it now. We're going to have sponsored Pokemon. We're going to have the Gold's Gym, Machoke. Machoke, the Taco Bell sponsored Hitman Lee,
Boba Fett brought to you by Fiber One.
Yeah,
I don't know. I just want to work Fiber One back into it.
The Slowpoke Pizza Hut. You know things. Oh man, actually no. If Pizza Hut was gonna sponsor a Pokemon, it'd probably be Magikarp because they're useless.
Yeah.
So is Splash.
Resident in Snorlax. There we go.
Sleep in, comfort in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Moving on. I don't know where to go after that. Moving on. I said about costumes at the beginning of the show, and it's our first costume related story. Street Fighter 4 announced that they're coming out with new costumes for the characters.
Oh.
Halloween themed costumes,
oh,
guys.
No.
They will be available just in time for Halloween on October 27th, 5 days in front of the holiday. So you'll be able to use them for at least 5 days before they become irrelevant.
Why?
In the screenshots that were released, Dan is a jack-o'-lantern. A really poorly designed jack-o'-lantern. Cody is a zombie, and so on. They look terrible, by the way.
Well, first picture you see is Dan, so it is terrible.
You can buy them in smaller packs for like $3.99, or you can buy them all for $20.
No.
Okay. My question to you guys is: do you guys think themed costumes are good for games? And like I said, we're going to get more into this in our final battle question later on, but do you guys think themed costumes are good for games?
Nope.
Especially at that price?
Nope.
For 5 days when they're relevant?
Yeah, no. All three of your questions are no.
Agreed.
Moving on, Bobby.
Agree to agree, guys.
I concur.
High five.
Sorg, what do you think?
Yes, Sorg.
Yeah, you like costumes, right, Sorg?
Sorg said fart noise.
All right. Speaking of fart noises, Hideo Kojima has left Konami. No way he's back.
No way he's gone again.
Oh, he's just on vacation. Oh.
In the ongoing saga
of Konami e Kojima, Konami is now saying that Hideo Kojima is back with the company, and that him and his staff are just on vacation now that Metal Gear Solid has been released.
No, they're not.
However, Konami hasn't said when or if Kojima-san will be returned from vacation.
He's never coming back.
An unnamed person at Konami said, because the development time for console games is so long and fatigue builds up, it's common for employees to take extended periods of time off when a developed game is finished. We'll hold them to that.
Does Konami think we're not that bright?
This whole situation is just weird. He's in or out. Why not just say that? You know,
it's sad because I have the game right over there.
Mm-hmm.
It was supposed to be a lot bigger.
Yeah, it wasn't finished.
Hideo Kojima game, and then they all of a sudden take it out.
And the game wasn't finished.
Yeah, I mean, Metal Gear Online is. By the way, Metal Gear Solid is amazing. Mm. You guys want
to
play it?
But I mean, there was supposed to be more to the story. And
there was.
Took a lot out.
And it is. But the way I'm saying it is, they want you to believe that Kojima and Konami are together.
Mm-hmm.
They're awesome. Nothing wrong has happened to them. Everybody, calm down. There's nothing to see here. But let's be real.
Go ahead.
His name isn't on the cartridge on the box. His name was supposed to be on the box. They said he's not here, but he's here. But he's not. He's not coming back.
Hideo's not here, man.
Hideo's not coming back.
This is my favorite part. I pulled this part out of the story because I wanted to read it. The denial comes after a report in the New Yorker that Kojima had left the building and company he worked for nearly 3 decades for a final time earlier this month. Simon Parkin reported for the New Yorker that there was even a going away party. But Konami writes it has no idea what that party was about.
There's a picture with them hosting him.
Guys. Do you know what's not confusing at parties?
cakes that say best of luck in your future endeavors.
Well, that too. But pizza is not confusing at parties.
There's nothing confusing about pizza here, Bobby. Slice on Broadway at sliceonbroadway.com here in the Pittsburgh area, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. Go check them out. And they are on the Twitters at PGH_Slice, as well as Slice on Broadway on Facebook and the Instagrams. Go check them out and let them know you heard about them here on Boss Battle with InsertCoinToBegin.com. Now let's take a look what happened this past week in Sorgatron Media.
Oh, dear. I don't mean to be indelicate, but do we have children to watch this show? Because I feel that perhaps they should not be watching this one.
I'm here with a fellow podcaster, Buzzy Torek of the Epicast Network.
If you just want to try a podcast, I'd say start doing them on your phone, get good at it. We have a popular podcast from Pittsburgh that is done all on an iPhone. Mm-hmm. I despise listening to it when I engineer it, but it's there and people don't seem to mind it. Just record your conversations and start getting better at having those conversations.
That is Jay Briscoe. There is no hype. There is no hyperbole. But was a Ring of Honor camp. He walked in. He was one of the coaches, and he had a stalk of raw broccoli in his hand, and he's taking chunks out of it as he's giving us instructions and telling us what to do and how to, where to be aggressive and where, and just raw broccoli. And there was a part of me that's like, is he helping with me? Is this?
I understood that it was a business and that you were working for someone and that you were taking someone's ideas and influence and making it your own. And I believe that you have to be extremely patient. I've been extremely patient. I didn't expect anything to be just handed over to me. I've wanted to work for it and I wanted to earn it. And I feel like if it's given to you, it's kind of, I don't know, it kind of depreciates it and devalues it.
I'm probably not your typical use case. I'm at my desk when I'm working for work, which is low processor, low memory intensive. I'm up here for the show. When I'm actually working on video, I'm usually on my couch. and so, like right now, I'm plugged into this huge monitor, right? If I were to edit video and hit render or save or whatever to actually render the video, I would grab the laptop and take it with me and open it up.
Oh, Rizz, you crazy cat. I can't believe you took Bobby's pants last week.
I don't think that actually happened. But,
no, it did.
I'm pretty sure it did.
But moving on.
You can go over to SorgatronMedia.com and check out everything we did last week, including Rizz taking Bobby's pants.
I still don't think that happened. But anyways,
you don't
want to
know what I did with
them. Speaking of pants and costumes that we talked about earlier in the show... Earlier in the show, we discussed video game costumes, and while horrible, they didn't cause much controversy. Well, there are some costumes in the latest version of Fatal Frame that have some gamers a little angry. Not because of what they are, but because of what they took away. In the U.S. version of Fatal Frame, Maiden of the Blackwater, that it's exclusive to the Wii U, the two main characters in the game, Yuri and Miyu, go around taking pictures of ghosts, and you can unlock costumes for each of the characters. Mm-hmm. In the U.S. version and the U.K. version of the game for the Wii U, you can have them walking around the creepy house as Samus from Metroid in the Zero suit and Princess Zelda from The Legend of Zelda. That's not the controversy. What some gamers are mad about, however, is the new costumes replaced, yes, you guessed it, the costumes replaced scantily clad costumes that the girls could wear in the game. You could even take pictures and film the characters in these costumes while they were sleeping, which is totally the Japan thing to do. But what a lot of American gamers are claiming that the move is censorship, and they want the ability to have the ladies in whatever costumes that are available in the original game. So the final battle question this week is, do you guys think it was right for Nintendo to replace the scantily clad costumes with the new versions, or do you agree with Nintendo's decision to remove the creepiness?
That's a good question.
I agree with Nintendo's decision to remove the creepiness.
Okay.
I'm surprised I haven't heard of this game before.
I played the one on PS2 a long time ago, and it was actually a really good survival horror game. Like, it was a fun game, and it wasn't creepy at all.
No,
like,
I mean, it was
creepy,
is,
but it was creepy in the horror kind of creepy, not this costume scantily clad creepiness.
Right. What I mean is, I can't believe that the female gamers of the Americas haven't let me hear about this game before.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's out yet.
Well, Fatal Frame's been around since like at least the PlayStation 2, maybe the PlayStation 1. It's always been a very obscure kind of title, though. So it probably hasn't been, you know, you had to be really into survival horror on any of those platforms. I guess it does kind of hit the edge of a socially acceptable kind of thing, and not the scantily clad, but is it because that you're able to take pictures of them sleeping?
They're basically wearing lingerie walking around.
Right. And I don't know. I feel like that's not the worst thing in video games.
No, it's not.
Here's the part I don't get. Hmm. It's still in Japan where you can do that, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they're only going to take it out in the American and Europe games.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
But why only that?
Because we're the only countries that have a population of women gamers mm-hmm. that are smart enough to say something and it's not against the culture. Mm-hmm.
Plus, the Wii U is generally geared more towards like a younger audience.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And
this is Nintendo of those countries saying something. Them looking at their society like, ooh, this isn't really cool over here as it is in Japan. Now Nintendo of Japan are like, I mean, the president of Nintendo owns Love Hotels. You know what I mean? It's different. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I think that's your big thing.
That'd be Pikachu girl.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Vending machine.
You guys talked me into that. That's freaking creepy.
But, you know. To be sure.
It's their decision. So, you know, they have a company that they make a lot of money. So they have the right to do whatever the hell they want to do.
Yeah. And it's not meant to be like a creepy. It's meant to be a creepy game, but not.
It is meant to be creepy.
But it's not like a creepy, perverted game. You know? So, what are you going to do? All right. Anybody, any more thoughts on that, guys? All right, that's going to do it for us this week. You can follow us on Twitter at InsertCoinTB. You can visit us at InsertCoinToBegin.com. New articles going up daily. And you can join us live each and every Tuesday night at 8 on live.sorgatronmedia.com. Sorg, you got any plugs?
Please check out Sawtooth Willie's YouTube and Facebook channel. You can just look up Sawtooth Willie on either of those platforms. And we got a lot of stuff going on at sorgatronmedia.com.
All right. Chachi, any plugs?
At Chachi says on the Twitters. What?
All right, Rizz, plugs.
Rizz plays games on Twitters. Rizz plays games on YouTubes. I actually just made another Mario Maker level, so I'll post that on my Rizz plays games and everything else. Other than that, InsertCoinToBegin.com.
All right, and I'm at BobbyFJTom. You can follow me on there, and we are doing our Extra Life 2015 campaign. Our team name is Uncharted 4 Drake's Donations, and you can donate. I'll tweet out the link so you guys can donate, and I'm going to post it on the site. All right, that's going to do it for us, guys. Game over.
This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.